Scientists are sounding the alarm. The risk of a sudden eruption has skyrocketed by an astonishing 320%. What's going on beneath the surface of this iconic park? And what does it mean for the millions who visit each year? Stay tuned as we uncover the shocking details and the science behind this unprecedented situation. So what led to the sudden and shocking shutdown of Yellowstone National Park? It all started with a series of alarming geological events that caught the attention of both park officials and scientists. Recently, Yellowstone has been hit by an unusual spike in seismic activity. We're talking about a series of small but frequent earthquakes shaking the park and causing significant ground swelling in several areas. These early warning signs suggested that something major was brewing beneath the surface. But the real game changer came when scientists detected a dramatic increase in volcanic activity indicators. New geysers were erupting, steam explosions were more frequent, and the ground temperatures in several hot springs were rising at an unprecedented rate. This wasn't just business as usual for Yellowstone. The data pointed to something far more serious. Experts quickly connected the dots. The increased seismic activity and thermal changes were signs that the supervolcano's magma chamber was becoming more active. For those who might not know, Yellowstone sits atop one of the world's largest active supervolcanoes. Any significant changes here are closely monitored because of the potential for catastrophic eruptions. In response to these alarming signs, park officials made the tough decision to close Yellowstone to ensure the safety of visitors and staff. Emergency response teams were dispatched, and advanced monitoring equipment was set up throughout the park to gather real-time data on the evolving situation. This shutdown isn't just about precaution, it's about understanding the full extent of what's happening beneath Yellowstone. Scientists are now working around the clock, analyzing seismic data, monitoring gas emissions, and using thermal imaging to get a clearer picture of the supervolcano's behavior. The decision to shut down the park was not made lightly, but the priority is clear: safety first. The increased risk of a sudden eruption, now believed to be 320% higher than previously estimated, has turned Yellowstone into a critical watch zone. Next, we'll dive into what makes Yellowstone's supervolcano so unique and why this increase in eruption risk is such a big deal. To truly grasp the gravity of the situation, we need to understand what makes Yellowstone's supervolcano so unique and potentially dangerous. Yellowstone's supervolcano is a geological giant, and it sits atop one of the most active volcanic hotspots on Earth. This massive magma chamber, located just a few miles beneath the surface, is a reservoir of molten rock created by the intense heat from the Earth's mantle. The sheer size of this chamber is staggering. It's estimated to be about 30 miles long, 20 miles wide, and up to 10 miles deep. That's enough molten rock to fill the Grand Canyon multiple times over. The supervolcano has a history of producing some of the largest eruptions ever recorded. The last major eruption occurred approximately 640,000 years ago, creating the vast caldera, or volcanic crater, that we see today. This eruption was thousands of times more powerful than any eruption in modern history, spewing ash and gases into the atmosphere and affecting the global climate for years. What makes Yellowstone particularly worrisome is the way it can produce different types of volcanic activity. Beyond massive eruptions, the park is home to more frequent geothermal phenomena like geysers, hot springs, fumaroles, and mud pots. These features are direct windows into the geothermal activity below and provide clues about the state of the magma chamber. The recent increase in seismic activity and ground swelling are significant because they suggest movement within the magma chamber. When magma rises, it can cause the ground above to bulge and crack, leading to earthquakes. These earthquakes can, in turn, cause steam explosions and new geyser activity as underground water comes into contact with hot rock. Scientists use a variety of tools to monitor Yellowstone's volcanic activity. Seismographs detect earthquakes, GPS stations measure ground deformation, and thermal cameras track temperature changes in the park's geothermal features. By analyzing these data points, experts can get a better understanding of what's happening beneath the surface. One crucial aspect of monitoring is the study of volcanic gases. Gases like sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide are released from magma and can provide early warnings of rising magma. Increased gas emissions often indicate that magma is moving closer to the surface, raising the risk of an eruption. Understanding Yellowstone's supervolcano isn't just about predicting eruptions. It's about preparing for the potential impacts. An eruption, even a minor one, could have significant consequences for the environment, air travel, and daily life across large parts of the United States and beyond. But with the risk of eruption increased by 320%, what exactly does that mean for the future? How are scientists responding to this heightened threat? Stay with us as we explore the alarming increase in eruption risk and what it means for Yellowstone and beyond. With Yellowstone's supervolcano showing signs of increased activity, scientists have now raised the alarm. The risk of a sudden eruption has increased by a staggering 320%. But what does this actually mean? And how did they come to this conclusion? The recent uptick in seismic activity was the first red flag. Small earthquakes, although common in geothermal areas, have become more frequent and intense around Yellowstone. These tremors are not just isolated incidents. They are part of a larger pattern indicating that the magma chamber beneath the park is becoming more active. Ground deformation is another critical indicator. As magma moves and accumulates, it causes the ground above to swell. In recent months, certain areas of Yellowstone have shown significant ground uplift. This swelling can put pressure on the crust, leading to an increased likelihood of eruptions. Scientists also pay close attention to the park's hydrothermal features. The appearance of new geysers, increased activity in existing ones, and unusual steam explosions all point to heightened volcanic activity. These changes suggest that the magma is interacting more vigorously with the groundwater system, increasing the risk of an explosive event. One of the most telling signs is the change in gas emissions. Volcanic gases like sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide are released from magma. When there's more magma moving towards the surface, the levels of these gases increase. Recent measurements have shown a significant rise in these emissions, indicating that magma is rising closer to the surface. So why a 320% increase in eruption risk? This figure comes from comprehensive models that combine all these factors: seismic activity, ground deformation, hydrothermal changes, and gas emissions. Using advanced technology and historical data, scientists can estimate the probability of an eruption. The current data points to a much higher risk than we've seen in decades. This isn't just academic speculation. The implications are serious. A sudden eruption at Yellowstone could have catastrophic consequences, not just for the immediate area, but for much of the United States and even the world. Ash clouds could disrupt air travel, affect climate patterns, and pose health risks to millions of people. Now, you might be wondering, what does this increased risk mean for the park's incredible wildlife and ecosystem? How are the animals and plants coping with these changes? Let's explore the impact on Yellowstone's fragile ecosystem and the efforts to protect it. Yellowstone's diverse wildlife and unique ecosystem are facing unprecedented challenges due to the increased volcanic activity. The frequent earthquakes and ground swelling are not just geological phenomena. They're directly impacting the habitats of numerous species. For example, animals like deer and elk are highly sensitive to ground vibrations and have been altering their migration patterns to seek safer areas. This disruption can lead to overcrowding in certain regions, increasing competition for food and water. Predators such as wolves and bears, which follow these herds, are also affected as their prey moves into less familiar territories. The park's waterways, fed by geothermal springs, are experiencing temperature changes that can be harmful to aquatic life. Fish and other aquatic species may struggle to survive in these fluctuating conditions, impacting the entire food chain. The microorganisms that thrive in the park's hot springs, some of which are found nowhere else on Earth, are particularly vulnerable to these changes. Plants are not immune either. The heat and chemical changes in the soil around geothermal areas can stress vegetation, leading to shifts in plant communities. This in turn affects the herbivores that rely on these plants for sustenance. Despite these challenges, Yellowstone's ecosystem has shown remarkable resilience over millennia. However, the current situation demands close monitoring and proactive measures. Biologists and ecologists are using advanced tracking techniques to study how wildlife is adapting to these changes and what can be done to support them. But what about the people whose livelihoods depend on the park? How is the increased eruption risk affecting tourism in the local economy? Let's delve into the economic and tourism consequences of Yellowstone's shutdown. Yellowstone National Park isn't just a natural wonder. It's a major economic hub for the surrounding region. With the sudden shutdown, the local economy is feeling the impact hard. Yellowstone attracts millions of visitors annually, driving revenue for hotels, restaurants, tour companies, and souvenir shops. The closure means canceled bookings and a sharp decline in income for these businesses. Many local residents rely on tourism for their livelihoods, and the shutdown has led to layoffs and reduced hours, putting financial strain on families. Beyond local businesses, the park's closure affects the broader tourism industry. Airlines, car rental companies, and travel agencies are seeing fewer bookings as potential visitors change their plans. Research and conservation efforts within the park are also halted. Scientific studies on geology, wildlife, and climate change are delayed, impacting critical research. Local governments are stepping in with emergency funds and relief programs to support affected businesses and workers. There's also a push to promote nearby attractions and alternative activities to draw visitors back to the region. Despite these challenges, the park's closure offers a chance for the environment to recover from the impacts of over-tourism. Reduced human activity can allow wildlife and natural landscapes to rejuvenate, potentially leading to long-term benefits for Yellowstone. But what do visitors have to say about the sudden shutdown? How are scientists and government officials responding to this unprecedented situation? As the situation at Yellowstone unfolds, government officials and scientists are working tirelessly to manage the crisis and mitigate the risks associated with the increased volcanic activity. Federal and state agencies have mobilized emergency response teams to monitor and manage the situation. Advanced seismic and volcanic monitoring equipment has been deployed throughout the park to gather real-time data. These tools help scientists track seismic activity, ground deformation, and gas emissions, providing critical information needed to predict potential eruptions. Dr. Emily Stone, a leading volcanologist, explains, "Our primary goal is to understand the behavior of the magma chamber and assess the likelihood of an eruption. We're analyzing data from multiple sources to get a comprehensive picture of what's happening beneath Yellowstone." Local authorities are also involved, working closely with national agencies to ensure public safety. Evacuation plans have been updated, and public information campaigns are underway to educate residents and visitors about the risks and safety protocols. In addition to monitoring and safety measures, efforts are being made to support the local economy. Relief programs have been initiated to help businesses affected by the park's closure. Community leaders are exploring alternative tourism opportunities, promoting nearby attractions and outdoor activities that remain open. The scientific community is not only focused on immediate concerns, but also on long-term research. The current situation provides a unique opportunity to study one of the world's most active volcanic systems in real time. Findings from this research could enhance our understanding of volcanic activity and improve predictive models, benefiting communities around the world. But what does the future hold for Yellowstone and its visitors? What precautions are being taken to ensure everyone's safety as the situation evolves? Let's explore the future predictions and safety measures being implemented to protect this natural wonder. Looking ahead, the future of Yellowstone National Park is uncertain, but proactive measures are being taken to safeguard both the park and its visitors. Scientists continue to closely monitor the supervolcano, using cutting-edge technology to track every movement. Enhanced early warning systems have been put in place to provide real-time alerts about seismic activity, ground deformation, and gas emissions. These systems are designed to give park officials and the public as much notice as possible in the event of an impending eruption. Public safety remains the top priority. Evacuation routes and emergency shelters have been established, and regular drills are conducted to ensure readiness. Information hotlines and mobile apps have been launched to keep residents and visitors informed about the latest developments and safety instructions. For tourists, visiting Yellowstone will come with new guidelines and restrictions. Certain high-risk areas may remain off-limits, and visitors will be required to follow strict safety protocols. These measures are intended to protect people while still allowing them to experience the park's natural beauty. On the research front, the increased activity at Yellowstone is providing valuable data that could help predict future volcanic events, not just here, but at other supervolcanoes around the world. Scientists are optimistic that the lessons learned from this situation will lead to better preparedness and response strategies globally. But what can you do to stay safe if you're planning a trip to Yellowstone? And how can you support the ongoing efforts to protect this incredible park? As we've seen, the situation at Yellowstone National Park is both fascinating and concerning. The increased risk of a sudden eruption has brought this natural wonder into the global spotlight, highlighting the need for vigilance and preparedness. If you're planning a visit to Yellowstone, stay informed and follow the guidelines provided by park authorities. Make sure to download the latest safety apps and familiarize yourself with evacuation routes and emergency procedures. Your safety is a top priority. Supporting Yellowstone goes beyond just being prepared. Consider donating to conservation and research efforts to help scientists continue their vital work. By contributing, you're helping to protect this natural treasure for future generations. And don't forget to share this video to raise awareness about the situation at Yellowstone. The more people know, the better prepared we can all be. If you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Science Nerd for more updates on this developing story and other fascinating topics so you never miss an alert. Stay safe, and we'll see you in the next video.